The Airbus A340, everything you need to know. The A340 was a significant development at the time of its launch. It marked Airbus's entry into the quad jet market and offered healthy competition for other manufacturers. Production of the A340 ended in 2011, but it remains in service with several airlines. It has been a big casualty of the slowdown in 2020, though, with retirements increasing. This guide takes a look through the history and development of the A340. Four variants were developed, and it was designed alongside the twin-engine A330. This was a smart move by Airbus, lowering costs, and covering the fact that the A340 soon fell out of favor as twins improved. The story of the A340 starts with the A300 and A320. The A300 was Airbus' first aircraft, in 1972. It was a twin-engine, twin-aisle aircraft, with a shortened variant, the A310. Following initial success with this, Airbus went on in the early 1980s to create a new twin-engine, single-aisle aircraft. There was a gap in the market here, with the US-manufactured Boeing 737 dominating and no European alternative. European governments realized this and worked with manufacturers on several proposals for a new, European-constructed, competitor. Airbus eventually won and went on to develop the A320 family. With the A320 project launched, and on the way to delivery, Airbus started to look at the market for larger, wide-body aircraft. Again, there was an opportunity to compete with Boeing in this area, especially with the 747 starting to sell well. A big question, however, was whether to develop a twin-engine or a four-engine, quad-jet, wide-body. We know now that extended-range twin-engine operations performance standards, ETOPS, ratings have made twin engines much more desirable. But at the time, there were still severe restrictions on how far twin-engine aircraft could fly from diversion airports, limiting their use for many airlines. The solution was to develop two aircraft, a twin-jet, and a quad-jet. This would meet the needs of both sets of customers, and there would be savings by developing both aircraft together. In 1986, the development project moved forward and became the A330 and A340. Airbus board chairman Franz Josef Strauss said at the time, "Airbus Industrie is now in a position to finalize the detailed technical definition of the TA9, which is now officially designated the A330, and the TA11, now called the A340, with potential launch customer airlines, and to discuss with them the terms and conditions for launch commitments. Developing the two aircraft together brought many advantages. They shared the same basic fuselage and wing design, and many structural components and systems, as well as a common flight deck. This, of course, saved money in the development and brought the aircraft to market faster than if they were designed separately. Airbus also made further savings by using designs from the A300 and A320. The fuselage of the A330 and A340 is based on a stretched A300 fuselage. And the fly-by-wire controls and cockpit are inherited from the A320. The main differences between the A330 and A340 are, of course, in the two or four engine setup. The A340 also has a larger wing and an additional middle rear landing gear. This middle landing gear is unusual. Most heavy aircraft use two gears with increased wheels to cope with the extra load. The main selling point of the A340 was its four engines, not necessarily its increased capacity or range. Airbus would return later to the high-capacity model later with the A380. Having four engines enabled it to operate longer overwater flights, something for which the A330 was restricted. ETOPS were introduced in the early 1980s, to reflect the increasing safety and performance of twin-engine aircraft and allow them to fly further from a diversion airport. The first rating was given, in 1985, to Trans World Airlines flying a 767. This allowed it to fly 120 minutes from a diversion airport. Before this, twin engines were restricted to flying 60 minutes from a diversion airport. The first, pre-ETOPS, extension to this was given to the A300, with a limit of 90 minutes. The A330 and A340 program was launched in June 1987, just before that year's Paris Air Show. At the time, there were 130 orders from 10 airlines. Aerospatiale constructed a new assembly facility at Colomiers, near Toulouse, France. This made extensive use of robotics and automation, another cost-saving move by Airbus. There were similar investments into production facilities in the United Kingdom by BAE, with a technical center at Filton and expansion of its wing production site at Broughton. The A340 took its first flight on October 21, 1991. During testing, Problems were discovered with some warping of the wings at cruising speed, and changes had to be made to the underwing to add stiffness. European certification was achieved in December 1992, with the US FAA certification following in May 1993. The first aircraft was delivered to launch customer Lufthansa on February 2, 1993, and it began service on March 15. The A340-200 is one of two initial variants, offered at launch in 1987. It is the shortest variant of the series, offering a typical two-class capacity of 303 and a little less for three-class. Both this and the 300 variant use CFM International CFM56-5C engines, providing thrust of 31,200 to just over 34,000 pounds. These were upgraded for later variants. Only 28 of this variant were ordered, with the slightly larger A340-300 proving much more popular. The A340-300 was also offered at launch. It was the first aircraft to be delivered to Lufthansa in 1993. It is stretched just over 4 meters from the A340-200, which increases the typical capacity from 303 to 335. Of the two launch variants, this was by far the most popular, with 218 delivered. It was also developed into an enhanced model, the A340-300E, with improved engines and upgraded avionics and cockpit systems, part of the development for the next two A340 variants. The A340-500 and 600 variants were developed in the late 1990s as higher capacity and increased range upgrades to the original two variants. They first flew in 2001, the 600, and 2002, the 500. The A340-500 was launched in March 2003 by Emirates, after the original launch customer, Air Canada, filed for bankruptcy. The 500 is stretched just over 4 meters from the 300. The focus, though, is not on increasing capacity but on expanding its range. It offers a similar capacity to the 300, but the range is increased to an impressive 16,670 kilometers, 9,000 nautical miles. This was the highest range of any aircraft until beaten by the A350 ULR. Singapore Airlines used the A340-500 for its Singapore to Newark service, now operated by the A350-900 ULR. The engines were switched to Rolls-Royce for these variants, offering significantly higher thrust. The 500 uses Trent 553 engines, and the 600 uses Trent 556 engines. The focus of the A340-600 was on capacity. It offers a similar passenger capacity to the Boeing 747 but adds additional cargo space. Virgin Atlantic was the launch customer in August 2002. It is stretched 12 meters over the 300, giving a typical capacity of 380, but with a maximum exit limit of 440. It was the longest aircraft in service, beating both the A380 and the Boeing 747-400, until the launch of the 747-8. Like the larger 300 variant, the 600 has been much more popular than the 500. Airbus delivered 97 aircraft, as opposed to just 32 of the 500 variant. It would use the same wing design, avionics, and engines, though, as the 300 was not popular with airlines. The 500 improved on this and became the option that airlines purchased. One of the aims of the A340 was to replace aging Quadjets, including the Boeing 707 and Douglas DC-8. This was a market Airbus had not yet entered but saw an opportunity to offer a more efficient competitor, using updated technology. The A340 also got an early boost when problems were found with the McDonnell Douglas MD-11. This trijet widebody first flew in January 1990, slightly before the A340. It soon became apparent, though, that it did not meet expectations for range and fuel efficiency. This was a problem for several airlines. In particular, Singapore Airlines had hoped to operate it between Singapore and Paris, but this would not be possible. As a result, it switched its order for MD-11 aircraft to A340-300s. Production of the MD-11 ceased in 1998, partly as a result of competition from the A340, and also the Boeing 767 and 777, with Boeing and McDonnell Douglas merging in 1997. The A340 at the time of its launch was designed to get around restrictions on twin-engine aircraft. With four engines, it could operate further from a diversion airport, importantly including long overwater routes. In the years that followed, though, restrictions were increasingly lifted on twin-engine aircraft. ETOPS 180 was first given in 1989, and the Boeing 777 became the first aircraft to receive this rating on launch, although in Europe it still had to demonstrate performance at ETOPS 120. The A330 was rated ETOPS 240 in 2009, and the 777 achieved ETOPS 330. and ratings now go as high as ETOPS 370 for the A350. With limits this high, there are very few restrictions on where the aircraft can operate. Airbus announced the end of the A340 program in November 2011. Bertrand Grabowski, managing director of the transport group at DVB Bank, summed up the industry views at the time, as reported in the Seattle Times, saying, "In an environment where the fuel price is high, the A340 has had no chance to compete against similar twin engines, and the current lease rates and values of this aircraft reflect the deep resistance of any airlines to continue operating it." The A340 has been declining in use since the mid-2000s. But the slowdown as a result of COVID-19 in 2020 has seen this increase significantly. As airlines have reduced operations, it is the larger four-engine aircraft that have suffered the most. Many 747 and A380 fleets have gone into storage or been retired early. And the A340 has not fared well. Given the dramatic decline in A340s and some early retirement of young aircraft, Iberia, for example, has retired its A340s with the youngest just 10 years old, it is tempting to call the A340 a failure. That, however, does not really explain it well. The A340 was not an unsuccessful aircraft. It served a purpose at the time, but the situation has changed since then. And the fact it was built alongside the A330 means its cost of development was lower, helping justify its more limited sales and use. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider supporting this channel by liking, sharing, and subscribing.